Here is the mannequin model, the torso model we'll be using for most of the digestive system. I'm going to start with the head. So over here is the head of the torso model, sagittal section. Over here is the oral cavity. This is the tongue, the hard palate, the soft palate, the uvula. This is the submandibular gland, the sublingual gland. And on the side of the head here is the parotid gland. Also able to see here is the oral pharynx and the laryngopharynx leading to the esophagus. The esophagus then continues through the thoracic cavity behind the heart. Then we get down to the abdominal cavity. And in the abdominal cavity, we have a ton of structures. Here is the liver with the right lobe and left lobe. On the bottom of the liver is the gallbladder there in green. So there's the gallbladder in green. Here is the stomach. So the esophagus connects to the stomach. This upper hump here is the fundus. This is the body, all of this area. And then the bottom portion of the stomach here is the pylorus. We open it up. All these ridges in here are the rugae. We have the lower esophageal sphincter here and the pyloric sphincter here. The stomach then leads to the curvature here of the small intestine called the duodenum. We're now able to see the pancreas with the pancreatic duct. Now the duodenum of the small intestine leads to this region of the small intestine called the jejunum. And then the jejunum leads to this region of the small intestine called the ileum. The ileum then leads to the large intestine. So here's the end of the ileum. Here's the part of the large intestine. This here is the ileocecal sphincter, which leads to the cecum of the large intestine. That's the appendix. Here's the transverse colon. Here is the ascending colon. This here is the transverse colon, which then leads to the descending colon. So this is the descending colon, which then leads to the sigmoid colon. And then you pull it up, and you can see way down here, the sigmoid colon is going to lead to the rectum, the anal canal, and the anus. It's also worth pointing out that this tissue here is part of the peritoneum. All right, that is almost it. Also, this white stripe running along the large intestine, that is the tinea coli. And each one of these little compartments, each one of these pouches, are individually known as a hostrum. So one hostrum, mini hostra. And that is it for the digestive system.